Hello students, now in this video we will discuss rest of the part of question number 5th. I am starting from third part. See here, tan theta upon 1 minus cot theta plus cot theta upon 1 minus tan theta is equal to, we have to prove 1 plus secant theta into cosecant theta. First of all, we will consider left hand side here. Firstly, convert all the term into sine and cos. Tan can be written as sine theta upon cos theta. In denominator, cot can be written as cos theta upon sine theta. Plus, here cot theta again, cos theta upon sine theta. And in denominator, 1 minus sine theta upon cos theta. Now take the LCM in denominator. Sin theta upon cos theta upon sin theta minus cos theta upon sin theta. Here again, cos theta upon sin theta, and in denominator take the LCM, it will become cos theta minus sin theta upon cos theta. Now we will take the reciprocal of denominator to solve the terms. Numerator fraction same, but denominator fraction will reverse, means to say reciprocal. Sin theta upon sin theta minus cos theta. Similarly, in second term, numerator fraction will same, cos theta upon sin theta, but in denominator fraction will take the reciprocal. Cos theta upon cos theta minus sin theta. Now, next step, see in the denominator, here is sin theta minus cos theta, but in second term there is cos theta minus sin theta. First of all, make it same term. If we will convert into sin theta minus cos theta, then there is a negative sign. So we will shift this negative sign here. It means to say our term will become, multiply the numerator terms, it will become sin square theta upon cos theta into sin theta minus cos theta. In second term, minus will shift here. Minus numerator's part multiplied cos square theta, this sin square theta, and this bracket will reverse, sin theta minus cos theta. Now we can take the common, 1 upon sin theta minus cos theta. In bracket, sin square theta upon cos theta minus cos square theta upon sin theta. Again take the LCM in the bracket. Sin theta minus cos theta as it is. If we will take the LCM, LCM will be sin theta into cos theta. So it will become sin cube theta, because 2 are here, sin square theta, here is only 1 sin theta, so if we multiply it will become 3 sin cube theta. Again here cos cube theta. Now we will apply the identity here, a cube minus b cube. What is the identity? A minus b bracket a square plus ab plus b square. Here A is sin theta, B is cos theta. Apply this identity in numerator. Other terms will remain same. Sin theta minus cos theta. And here it will become sin theta minus cos theta. Bracket sin square theta plus cos square theta plus sin theta into cos theta. And denominator same, sin theta into cos theta. Here see, these terms will be cancelled, these are in multiplied. Here identity, sin square theta plus cos square theta will become 1. And last term, sin theta into cos theta same. Now we will separate the denominator. First of all, shift this complete denominator in denominator of 1 and then to this term. 1 upon sin theta cos theta. So So it will be cancelled. Same term. So sin theta cos theta upon sin theta cos theta will become 1. Now sin theta is the reciprocal of cosecant theta. Cos theta is the reciprocal of secant theta. So this is the term which we have to prove. Cosecant theta into secant theta plus 1. You know addition is commutative, so you can write 1 plus secant theta into cosecant theta. This is your right hand side. Next, fourth part, you can solve it by yourself. Next, I am discussing question number 5. Fifth part, cos a minus sin a plus 1 upon cos a plus sin a minus 1. We have to prove it equals to cosecant a plus cot a. So, see, first of all, we need cot here. Cot, so divide numerator and denominator by sin A. Because cos upon sin is cot. Cos upon sin, cot. Sin upon sin, 1. 1 upon sin is cosecant A. Again in denominator, cos upon sin, cot plus 1 minus cosecant A. Now we need this term cosecant A plus cot A. So we multiply and divide by same term. Cosecant A plus cot A upon cosecant A plus cot A. Divide numerator and denominator, or you can say multiply and divide by the same term, which we have to need to prove. Now numerator will remain same, there is no change in numerator, cosecant A plus cot A, but in denominator you have to multiply the terms, firstly cot to both the terms, then 1 to both the terms, then cosecant to both the terms. Then there will be total 6 terms. See, cot A into cosecant A plus cot square. First of all, I had multiplied cot A to both the terms. Then multiply 1 cosecant A plus cot A. Then minus cosecant to both the terms. It will become minus cosecant square A minus cosecant A into cot A. The terms which are same with opposite sign will cancel. So this term, first and last term, will be cancelled in the denominator. And see, cot square A, cosecant square A, it is the identity. Same numerator, same. Cosecant A plus cot A. And in denominator, these two terms will same. Cosecant A plus cot A. But for these two terms, there is identity. Cot A minus cosecant square A is minus 1. Because identity is cosecant square minus cot square A is equals to 1. But if we write cot square at first term, then identity will become minus 1. So this whole bracket is same. Cot is in plus, cosecant plus, 1 is in minus. This complete term is cancelled. So we are left only with this term, cosecant A plus cot A. This is, we have to prove in right hand side. Now see, sixth part. Square root of 1 plus sin A, 1 minus sin A, we have to prove it equals to secant A plus tan. So, this part we will take left hand side, 1 plus sin A upon 1 minus sin A. This is the same procedure you are using to rationalize the terms. But if you are rationalizing the term, then this sign will convert into positive. If there is a negative sign, you will write positive. If there is positive, then there is negative. Same procedure we will apply here. You can say multiply and divide by 1 plus sin A. In numerator, it will become 1 plus sin A whole 1/1 sin square is cos square. Now this square is cancelled with square root. We are left only with 1 + sin a / cos a. Now separate the denominator. 1 + 1/cos is secant. Sin / cos is tan. So this we have to prove secant a plus tan. Next, 7th part. You can solve it by yourself. I am giving the hint. From numerator, take out sin theta, and from denominator, take out cos theta. So the brackets will become same by using the first identity. Clear? Next, I am discussing question number 8. 8th part, sin a plus cosecant a whole square plus cos a plus secant a whole square. We have to prove it equals to 7 plus tan square a plus cot square a. So first of all, open the identity. Sin square a plus cosecant square a plus 2 sin a into cosecant a. Similarly, here cos square a plus secant square a plus 2 into cos a into secant. Here first term is sin square a and here is cos square a. So if you will combine both the term, it will become identity. Sin square a plus cos square a, it will become 1. We will write here separately. Again, cosecant square a and secant square a. We didn't need these terms, so we will convert into cot. It can be written as 1 plus cot square a. Secant square can be written as 1 plus tan square a. Now we are left only with two terms, 2 sin a cosecant a. Sin and cosecant are reciprocal of each other, so it will be cancelled. We are left only with 2. Again, cos and secant are reciprocal of each other. So we will write secant as 1/cos. Cos is cancelled. So again we are left with 2. Now simplifying. Here is 1. Again 1. Again 1. And in last there are 2 2. So cos square a plus tan square a is same. Here 1 plus 1 plus 1. 3 plus 2 5 plus 2. 7. So we have to prove 7 plus tan square a plus cot square a. Next, 9th part, we will discuss 9th part, cosecant a minus sin a into secant a minus cos a. We have to prove it equals to 1/tan a plus cot a. First of all, we will solve its left hand side. To solve left hand side, convert cosecant into sin because cosecant and sin are reciprocal of each other. Sin same. Again in sitting bracket, secant can be written as 1/cos. Now take the axiom 1 minus sin square a upon sin a, 1 minus cos square a upon cos a. Here it will become identity. 1 minus sin square can be written as cos square a. Denominator same. Similarly, it will become sin square a. It will cos a. 1 cos is cancelled, 1 sin is cancelled. So we are left only with cos a into sin a. Now, but right hand side is 1/tan a plus cot a. So here we have to solve right hand side also. To solve right hand side, convert tan and cot to sin and cos. Tan can be written as sin a upon cos a. Cot can be written as cos a upon sin a. Now take the LCM in denominator. Sin a cos a is LCM. So here sin square a plus cos square a. It will become identity. This is denominator fraction. So we have to take its reciprocal to shift into numerator. Once say this is denominator fraction, so take the reciprocal. Sin a cos a upon sin square a plus cos square a. It will become identity. So 1 into sin a cos a upon 1. This 1 if we will divide by 1 same term, multiply by 1 same term. So the answer is sin a into cos a. So left hand side is equals to right hand side. Now only 10th part is left. 10th part is same as your 4th question, 4th part. You can solve it by yourself. Hope you all understand the trigonometric identity. Thank you so much.